Hi, welcome to this video. Let's see how to edit clips in 2DIP with Cyberlink PowerDirector 13. Give us suggestions to improve our videos through comments. You have four main kinds of clips inside the timeline: the image clips, the video clips, and the audio and text ones. Each of them can be edited and personalized differently by double-clicking on each of them. If you double-click on a text clip, you will open the Title Designer window to edit and type in. If you want to know how to manage 2D and 3D text, watch the related video in this guide. If you double-click on Sound Clips, the Trim Audio window appears. This lets you stretch the sound clip more precisely than using the main timeline. You can zoom in and out, clicking and dragging on the timeline above. Then place the playhead and click on the two buttons below. Use the left one to decide where the clip must start, and the right one to decide where it must finish. Below, select original to hear the sound clip as it is. Whereas click on output instead to hear just what is not cut off. When you click on OK, just the clip in output mode remains in the main timeline. You can come back to trim audio if you want to stretch the clip again as it was. You can also trim video clips more precisely, simply selecting them and going to trim above the timeline. If you double-click on an image or a video clip, you will open the PiP designer. To see how this works, let's take a PiP example. The PiP, that stays for picture in picture, is when you place a picture or a video with a smaller size on a bigger picture or video that stays behind. Such PiP designer recalls this PiP since many effects you find inside the PiP designer can be seen if you are placing a smaller clip on another one. You can do this by putting an image or a video on a lower video track and smaller in size, using the clip mode of the preview. If you have problems at using the clip mode, watch the beginner tutorial of this guide. Once done, double-click on such smaller clip. The PiP designer has its own preview from which you can check your clip. You can check and zoom in out using the icons in the top right corner. Below, you have the player and a local timeline, which is referred to the clip interested. On the left, you have different effects you can add. As said before, many of these do work properly in case you use this PiP effect. Chroma key makes parts of the clip transparent, depending on the color you want to make transparent. Enable the tool, checking it first. Choose the color with the eyedropper and set the right gradients more at the bottom. You can check again to disable the effect. You can also apply shadow and reflection. First enable them and adjust the settings, checking the preview on the right. Use border instead if you want to add some contour or grow inside. Use flip to mirror the clip horizontally or vertically. Don't care about 3D settings and fades for now. New in Cyberlink PowerDirector 13 is the object settings. Here you can set the opacity level of the clip, which means its transparency, the position and the rotation very precisely. And in scale you change the width, W, and the height, H, of the clip, K, keeping constant or not the aspect ratio. Then, if you go to Motion tab, you can give to your clip a motion path. Click on Path and observe the arrows shown. These indicate the kind of motion to apply to the clip. If you select one, the motion path appears as a light green line on the preview. Play all to see how it works. You can also change the motion path itself, dragging its nodes. The white nodes for scaling, the green one to rotate, and the yellow ones to shape the trajectory. Drag the edges and the segments to build curves. If you move it, you will of course move the clip as well. To remove any motion, just select the blue cross on the left. You can use rotation settings to apply motion by rotating only. Just define the final degrees of rotation and which direction. If you choose a value over 360, you will simply make more than one single loop. More at the bottom, you can also enable and regulate motion blur. This is great to make movement and motion more realistic. The faster the clip moves, the better blur makes the final effect. These motion paths and rotations do last as long as the clip lasts. So the shorter is the clip, the faster the motion path or rotation is completed. Remember, when you play the preview, to come back changing settings, you must first click on the stop button or wait the player to finish. During the preview, you can't edit any of the properties just set. You must stop it to go on editing. Then you have the mask tab. Masking is an effect that hides parts of a clip. Inside mask properties, choose how to hide these parts. The white area shown by the sample is the part of the clip that stays visible. You can also invert the mask or apply more feather below. You can personalize this better, going more below. Once you're done with the clip, click on Save below. You can also apply effects that do change in time. To do this, you need to use the local timeline and the keyframes. To know more about the keyframes, watch the next video in this guide. Although we have seen all these on a video clip, do not worry. All scene works in the same way inside a PiP designer on an image clip. Thanks for watching. Check out this guide for more.